This video will show you how to correctly install and operate the Dutton-Lainson DLB1000ASL brake winch. Your first step to install the winch is to correctly mount it with three bolts through the three slots in its base. Put a handle and handle nut on each drive shaft so they face the opposite direction from each other. Then tighten the handle nuts with a 15/16 inch wrench to hold them in place. Before you install cable onto the winch, we find it helpful to use a standard set of pliers to put a kink about 2 inches from the end of the cable so it looks like this. Slip this end underneath the reel's drum, then through the slot on the non-gear side plate. Bend the cable where you made the kink, then press it down over the square hole in the side plate. Insert the carriage bolt through both the square hole on the reel and the loop you just created in the cable. Place the cable clamp so the bolt fits through its hole and its winged edges fit over the cable. Set the nut on the end of the bolt with your fingers, then use a 7/16 inch wrench to tighten it completely. The cable clamp area should now look similar to this. Crank one of the winch's handles to wind the rest of the cable onto the reel, making sure that the cable comes off the bottom of the reel, not the top. Have a firm grip on the cable and pull back pretty hard on it as it's being wound to ensure that it gets distributed onto the reel in nice, even layers. Once you have wound the cable onto the winch, attach its hook to your load to hold it tight on the reel. Finally, make sure the ratchet paws are properly aligned and engaged with the ratchet wheel. Here are a few things to keep in mind as you use the winch on a day-to-day basis. First, you'll notice that when you lower your load, the ratchet wheel does not rotate, so the winch operates silently. When you lift your load, the ratchet paws engage the rotating ratchet wheel, which produces a clicking noise that sounds like this. Make sure that the brake hub assembly always rotates freely on the intermediate drive shaft, and that it does not become wedged too tightly against the shaft shoulder. Also be sure that the winch's gears and stub acme threads on the intermediate drive shaft are always properly lubricated. This winch can be operated in a fast or slow speed. To change between the speeds, stop cranking the handles, then use them to shift the primary drive shaft in the desired direction according to the label on the winch. Thanks for watching.